Good morning, dear students. This is the second part of the chapter. The name of the chapter is Chhatrapati Shivaji, founder of the Maratha Empire. In 1666, Aurangzeb invited Shivaji to Agra along with his 9-year-old son, Shambhaji. Dear students, don't be confused, as earlier I have mentioned Shambhaji as Shivaji's brother. He was Shambhaji Shahaji Bhosle, and this Shambhaji was Shivaji's eldest son, who was the next ruler after Shivaji. In his court, Aurangzeb made Shivaji stand behind the mansabdars as an insult. Shivaji became very offended. He wanted to come out from the court, but he was immediately put under house arrest. Shivaji's spies informed him that Aurangzeb had planned to move Shivaji or kill him. So Shivaji wanted to escape from there. Shivaji planned a nice trick. Shivaji pretended that he was very ill and requested Aurangzeb to send most of his army back to the Deccan. On his request, he was allowed to send sweets and gifts to saints and temples in Agra as offerings for his health. After a few days and weeks, one day Shivaji and his son Shambhaji hid themselves in one of the boxes and escaped in 1666. After Shivaji's escape, a treaty was signed that lasted till 1670, when Shivaji again launched a major attack against the Mughals and recovered all his lost territories from them. Dear students, see the picture. This is the coronation ceremony of Shivaji. Shivaji was crowned king of the Marathas in a lavish ceremony in Raigarh on June 1674. Shivaji was an able administrator. He formed a cabinet of ministers, or Ashtapradhan, a group of 8 ministers to assist the king. Though Persian was the court language, but Shivaji replaced it with Marathi. Marathi became Shivaji's court language. He emphasized on Hindu culture and traditions. He was a devout Hindu, but respected to all religions. He allowed his subjects freedom of religion and opposed any forceful conversion. Shivaji demonstrated great skills in military organization. He built a powerful navy. There was always a standing army. He captured important forts and laid the foundation of self-rule. He constructed many forts and rebuilt and repaired many forts for the security of his empire. Today, Shivaji is considered a national hero in India, especially in Maharashtra. He is also recognized as a warrior legend who sowed the seeds of Indian independence. Thank you, children. I hope you have understood it and have a nice day. Thank you.